So today we're taking a look at Canary Mail. This is an email client that many people want to look at because of the AI features. And we're going to explore them in this video and see whether they're any good for you managing your inbox. So welcome everyone, my name is Francesco Delessier, and if you're interested in productivity tools or tools to help you work, software for life, then jump over to toolfinder.co to explore more. You'll find Canary Mail below, as well as useful resources in the email space if you're continuing to search for the best email client. So let's jump over to Canary Mail and sort of give you the run over. This app is available on a wide range of devices, some of them outlined here, and we'll talk about pricing as well a little bit later on. So here we are with Canary Mail, and it's available on Mac here, and you can see that I'm using it. And first things first, the feel and look very similar to Apple Mail, and even those like Airmail, those sort of cleaner, easier, simpler applications. Now, the one thing you can do straight from the get-go is connect up an account. And this is free to use, so you can connect up, I believe, as many accounts as you want, because I added two Gmail and one, both of them Google Workspace accounts, but you can connect iCloud, Outlook, Exchange, Office 365, Yahoo, and other as well. So that's one of the first ports of call, and I'm on a trial of the Pro experience, so I will show you the AI features. So first things first, when you go to reply to an email, it comes up in a very simple fashion. Now you'll see that sent from Canary. You can also manage a signature inside of your inbox too, but this is your inbox. So this is my work inbox. I can see labels. I can see any of the regular stuff like snoozed, which you can do, send later, and manage spam and trash. Now, if I right click on the email, I can do all sorts of things, for example, label it, move it, block it, etc., and regular stuff you'd expect to see in a more modern email client. Now, the one thing you can do is if you select all of the emails that are in there, you can also do a feature called Bulk Cleaner Active, which means that you can select all the emails and identify them as unimportant emails. So it's just something that's going to save you a bit of time. Now, as you can see, you can interact with the email with all the stuff I just showed. You can snooze stuff up here. For example, I can snooze this to tomorrow. I can also be able to search within the email, which is quite helpful. And over on this right-hand side, you can see the AI features, which I think is probably one of the reasons why you may be here, because this application is touting itself as an artificial intelligence experience. Before we get to that, there are some additional experiences that you can do. For example, read receipts are available through this, so you can see anything that's just been read from your inbox. And also you can see and filter based on unread attachments and unanswered, which is a helpful feature. Now the AI feature is really helpful. For example, if you wanna summarize an email, you can have that appear on the right-hand side. And you can see here that it's just summarized it quite easily. Now, the only limitation to this is that it does only limit you to 400 newest emails per account. I don't know why, maybe that's because of the limits and rates they're gonna hit. But you can also see that you can either search this thread, which is the email in question, or everywhere across your account. Everywhere across your account gives you a few additional abilities. So for example, you can see the show my availability, which will give you an indication of, for example, what you've got today. And I can say Monday the 20th, and that's probably going to assume it's January because that's today. And what it's doing is I've given access to my calendar and my contacts. So it should go through and see that the only slot available is between these windows of time. And that's quite a helpful little feature to be able to break through into your calendar. But there is a tab up here which allows you to see your calendar. And because I was past 1:30, I actually didn't have anything on this calendar. It analyzed only the slots that I'm available on and assuming that I finish work at 5 p.m., which is a helpful feature. You can open this up as well. It's not really like a calendar app per se, but it does have some really basic abilities. Now up here, you can also use the assistant to search your inbox to find stuff. So you can use the email to search your inbox as well. And you can see search my email history, obviously only 400. And you can also perform tasks for my mailbox as well. You can compose new emails, which is a helpful way. So for example, firing a employee, you could say. And what it's going to do is start composing that within this window, which is a helpful feature. So in terms of AI features, you can then start composing, or you can adjust it based on some of the attributes, like whether you want it shorter, more formal, etc., which you might typically use. Now, I think the best thing next to do is show you the settings. The settings are pretty extensive. So for example, you can choose to have this off even if you're paying for premium. And I'll give you a lowdown of what the premium is in a moment. You can also set up things like analytics, whether you want them on and off, and also quite a high level of customization like fonts, size of messages, and things like that, which is all helpful. You can also set read receipts up or turn them off and delay send as well. Now, there are also abilities like custom swipes, which are good for mobiles, narrowing down your snooze and what secure send access you want as well. And you can see here that there are a bunch of keyboard shortcuts. You can also set up sync between device, which means that you can access it between devices, which is really helpful for mobile. And you can see the apps that I've got set up, the accounts with folders, aliases, and auto BCC. Now, I want to show you the signatures because you can set up a signature from here. So you can change this if you want to. You can add additional ones. And you can, I save that signature, but you can add more if I want to. You can also use templates, rules, security, and there's something called PGP here, which means pretty good privacy. I thought it meant something much more smart than that, but you are able to access that, which means it's encrypting, but it's worth exploring what that is because I'm not a security expert. But there is secure send, which means that any files are sent. That means that it's processed through secure send. And you can connect your team and Todoist and Asana. Now, in terms of the general feel of this application, it's got a good, easy look. It's not going to blow anyone out of the water, but the AI features are pretty good in terms of what they give to you in terms of pro experience. It also helps you to unify your inbox, which some other apps don't do as well, but this is a nice experience for that. Now, it's not going to be the most attractive, the fastest, the most powerful tool in terms of AI, but it is going to give you a good basic experience with a fairly reasonable premium. Let me show you what the premium pricing is. So this is the premium pricing. You do get the majority of the features as part of the free account, but then the AI features start from $3 per user per month, which I think is fairly reasonable. There's also the calendar and scheduling and the integrations that I showed you and that inbox cleaner at $36 a year. Now, there is a pro experience, which does give you access to that encryption, more privacy, and also $100 a year, which I think isn't going to be vastly different. And there's a full breakdown of what's exactly included in each of them. It seems that the majority of the free is the basic experience. Growth is AI and calendar, and pro plus is security, if that's what you want to focus on in mind. So that was Canary Mail. It's a really interesting app. If you're somebody that wants a little bit of an upgrade from those like Apple Mails, Air Mails, the really good looking ones, but are simple in nature. If you want something that's fairly reasonably priced, then this is an interesting option for you that has a dose of artificial intelligence. So thank you so much for stopping by. I look forward to helping you find the best email client. So if you are hunting still, even after this video, you can jump over to toolfinder.co and narrow down by email apps. So thanks very much, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio.